Public safety announcement for the college football world. But I want to come on here and talk about a few things today. And want to give a shout out to Steve Sarkisian, another rehab coach. Came to Alabama and had some success with Nick Saban ball players and learning from Nick Saban himself. You know, I want to say congratulations to the University of Texas. Y'all have received another rehab coach at the University of Alabama. You know, Texas people, let me tell y'all something. Y'all got a good coach, but let me tell y'all something. Jim McElwain was an offensive coordinator. Doug Nussmeier was an offensive coordinator. Lane Kiffin was an offensive coordinator. Brian Daboll was an offensive coordinator. Mike Locksley was an offensive coordinator. And Steve Sarkisian was an offensive coordinator. Everybody I just called out to you has won a championship or either played in a championship for the University of Alabama, all right, under Nick Saban. And everybody except McElwain was, you know, McElwain was homegrown under Nick Saban. Everybody else was a rehab coach. A rehab coach. So University of Texas, y'all may be what y'all call that, grab a bull by the horns or hook the horns or whatever y'all do over there. It don't make no difference to me. But let me give y'all a fair warning. I know y'all watched the national championship game the other night when we beat the Buckeyes. But don't think 1 minute your team gonna look like that. Hey, don't think 1 minute your team gonna look like what y'all saw the other night. Let me tell y'all something. Texas Longhorn. Y'all get to know me real well, Bama Mo. All right? Let me tell y'all something. Your team won't look like that. Your team, go look up y'all recruiting right now. Your team got a bunch of 3-stars, ball players. All right? That team you saw the other night was a bunch of 5- and 4-star ball players with a 5-star general coach. Y'all don't have none of that. Y'all don't have none of that. All right? You know, Charlie Strong came in there. Y'all thought he was going to be the guy to make y'all whatever y'all think y'all need to be. But, and then y'all hired Tom Herman. And y'all thought y'all was going to be whatever y'all thought y'all was going to be. You know? Let me tell y'all something, Texas Longhorn. Y'all got all the money, man. Y'all done got 4 coaches. Steve Sarkisian. Cal Flood. Jeff Banks. And some other coach. Probably was a rehab coach. To come to Texas. But I understand what y'all want. Everybody do. Because everybody, like Jim McElwain, Brian Daboll, Doug Nussmeier, Mike Locksley, Lane Kiffin, and Steve Sarkisian. They all want to be just like Alabama. But it's a problem. It's a problem. Nick Saban didn't go to Texas. Nick Saban didn't go to Texas. Texas people, I wish y'all would get a grip of yourself. You know what I'm saying? You know, all I'm saying, listen, y'all got a great coach in Steve Sarkisian. I like Steve. I really do. I wasn't prepared for him to stay there but a year or two anyway, because that's what all the offensive coordinators do. They come there, win, and learn from the best, from Nick Saban, Coach Nick Saban, the five-star general of college football. And then everybody think that, man, I got to have Alabama offensive coordinator. I got to have Alabama defensive coordinator. You know, y'all come get every coach you want off our staff. Just don't mess with Nick Saban. You know what I mean? Just don't mess with him. He ain't going nowhere. But I'm tired of rehab coaches, man. But we got another rehab coach. We just hired Bill O'Brien. You know, another rehab coach. But anyway, we turn them into great coaches. When they, you know, they a rehab coach. When they come to Alabama, we fix them up, you know. But, and Steve Sarkisian, Texas Longhorn, let me tell y'all what you got. You got a good coach, but don't stress the man out. Listen to me. I'm asking y'all, I'm begging y'all. Don't stress Steve Sarkisian out. Because we ain't going to take him back this time. You know what I'm saying? If you go down to the... If Steve Sarkisian get out to a bad start and y'all start pressing him, he got to speak over here at this banquet. He got to speak over here at that banquet. He got to recruit. He got to keep his home life together. Don't stress the man out. He don't need to go trying to... butcher no damn cow or nothing, you know, no bull. He don't need to be learning all that, you know. He don't need to be walking around with no cowboy hat on his head. He don't need none of that. Don't stress the man out. Y'all stress that man out, that man gonna go back to drinking again. If y'all stress that man out, he'll be down there at the in Austin at the local bar, the Bar and Grill. Don't do that. Don't, hey, Steve Sarkisian, hey, man, I like you, man, but don't let them folks stress you out trying to act like and be like and imitate the University of Alabama Nick Saban, because they know damn well, and you know damn well, it ain't finna help. You know what I'm saying? But Texas, you know, hey, y'all had to do what y'all had to do, but let me tell you, y'all gonna win a national title. Y'all gonna win a national title. y'all brought Steve Sarkisian in that light. Y'all flew him in like Alabama flew Nick Saban in. You know, a private jet. You know what I'm saying? Tom Herman and Charlie Strong got a damn taxi ride. They got an Uber ride to the University of Texas when they got their job. Y'all flew Steve Sarkisian in, a rehab coach. Y'all flew him in. But Texas Longhorn, y'all gonna win a championship, man. You know, y'all gonna win one after Nick Saban retire, just like the rest of these damn rehab coaches when they leave thinking they gonna win a championship. Just hang in there. But Alabama fan, let me tell y'all something before I leave, man. Y'all already know we don't give a damn who leave. You know what I'm saying? Long Nick Saban stays in Alabama, we good. So all we want to do is give a shout out to the University of Texas. In 2 years, look for the Alabama Nation to be on y'all ass. Y'all ain't stole nothing from us for us as a coach. Only thing y'all did, we ain't got to guard the alcohol at the stadium no more. Raw damn time.